Hello, this is Mocha Product Manager Martin Brennand with a super quick tip on PowerMesh tracking. So, you're doing a PowerMesh track to add a logo or some freaky looking scars, and the mesh just isn't working out. Before you start retracking with different settings, here's a way to make everything easier. First, draw your shape and set the planar settings. But now stop. Don't hit the mesh tracking button just yet. Do your planar track and make sure it's solid. Whee! Look at that! So smooth! Now, you can turn on your mesh, but before you do anything else, click Existing Planar Data in the Motion option. This means that any future tracking will not retrack that planar portion of the motion. Now you can track your power mesh, making it much quicker to play with settings and retrack. You can also try different iterations of power mesh tracks by drawing a new layer, setting the mesh motion and existing planar data, and then linking your planar track from the original layer. The advantage of this approach is that the planar layer's shape can be entirely different from your mesh track layer, allowing for more flexibility on how the mesh is placed versus how much data you can capture from the planar surface. Both these approaches allow much more experimentation and adjustment of the PowerMesh track without having to redo everything from scratch. So that was the quick tip. If you've got any other questions, you can ask them directly in the comments or pop over to the forums at borisfx.com. While you're there, we've got plenty of other Mocha tutorials, along with all the other delightful BorisFX products. So go check out borisfx.com, and we'll see you next time in the next tutorial.